Hey guys, it's Will. Hopefully you're having a great day today. In this one, we're going to go over APLD stock. We've seen some recent momentum related to the data center market over the last really month now. We've seen it start to see some surges and recover from back down around $19 a share up to $32 a share. And most data center companies have been on a run. You see consecutive green candlesticks over the last 9 or 10 days for APLD stock, and we've seen it recently start to find some resistance levels here and then sell back down. So yesterday, or the day before yesterday, we were actually looking at APLD and anticipating what was a recovery similar to this, about a 15% continuation up into that $35 range. Now it actually surged more than that. We saw it jump not 15%, but actually 25% just for a second in the pre-market hours before selling back down here into this support level around $29 a share. So continuing some of this uptrend, you can kind of see it even sold down at market open, and we start to see it continue to potentially recover back up into these levels here. So nearest support levels, if you're looking at where to watch closely, you're going to want to look at least from a technical standpoint, if you're looking at that, it's going to be right there. That previous resistance around $30 a share is where it recently kind of pulled back to from that big run and bounced. And that's the nearest level of support. If it can break above this $31.50 range that it's struggling to break up above right now, then that would be the next level of support for it in a bullish momentum play here. But again, resistance currently at that $31.50, that's where it is right now. Maybe it can break up above and then continue that trend. But right now it's got that resistance there in their overall uptrend that we've seen over the last few weeks. You can see that trend really kicking in, which is pretty easy to follow. But again, volatility is pretty heavy on the near term because of, well, general market conditions, but also their deals and what they've had come out with in their company recently, what they've come out with. What you can tell from, you know, when we're looking at the charts, this is one thing, but you got to look at, you know, the overall big picture. If we take a step back and just look at the 1 year and just see that market cap build from $3 a share here up to 31 now, so a 10x, APLD is one of the top companies that we've invested in this year. And we just entered a position last week, actually, in our daily live trading session in StockMate, where we're already up 63% over the last week and a half trading APLX. So at this point, you know, we're looking at a really nice surge, and potentially we see it continue up into those levels around $40 a share. But you got to kind of look at the financials. You got to look at what they currently have. I would love to get ahead of ourselves, look at some of the deals that they have, which they look very promising. But where the market cap is now at $8.8 billion, and then you can see their quarterly revenues holding around $60 million to $70 million, they're increasing their revenue, which is good. That revenue is up 84%, but their net income still negative. Okay, so not anything surprising there. You'd like to see them have positive profit margins as they are in the data center market. And the data center market that they're in, they're over in the data center market of building for top hyperscalers like CoreWeave, the data centers in some of the most innovative ways, from the point of generation, meaning that they are getting energy sources in wind, in solar, in hydroelectric, but also they're building out their data centers for multiple tech companies and have about $16 billion in their pipeline right now. And if you look at some of their partners they work with, you know, NVIDIA, Supermicro Computer, Intel, Dell, and Hewlett Packard. So data center markets are growing, but then you got to, again, once again, jump back into the financials. Revenue still hasn't caught up. They got $15 plus billion, actually $16 billion, in AI factories, but their revenue still at $64 million. They just secured these contracts really in this last quarter for the $16 billion. So what's likely to happen is why we see a kind of trend up right now is imagine if some of those leases hit the balance sheet or hit the income statement. Now you're going to see, that market cap probably do a lot better. You're going to see the income rise to hundreds of millions of dollars per quarter. You'd see that market cap probably jump up to around 20 billion or so. Now that's perfect scenario. It looks like they're positioning for that as they're also getting more capital. They've jumped from over 100% in their total assets up to 2.4 billion. But while they got cash, the revenue, is still low. And then you're looking at, okay, what's coming? Probably we're seeing more growth. There's a reason why, if we pull them up here inside of the Prophecy app, let's go ahead and pull them up using Claude. Next month is anticipating more surges above that $32 range. And the analysis indicates right now that they actually have some growth related to their investors and insiders. So you got Nvidia being a top investor, but it's not just Nvidia. It's also BlackRock, Vanguard, you got State Street and a ton of other investors. And you have more buys than sells when you're looking at the analysis. So Claude actually indicates the AI that we're using here indicates that it's we're seeing some more institutional growth and interest into the company. And then we're looking at the projections. Once again, you could look at the next month, actually anticipating an 8% gain here. You can wait a second, see if we get the next year loaded up. I'd like to actually look at the next year and then into the next week or so. Let's see if we can get that. There we go. Next day, they're anticipating up to $33. I mean, this is a very bullish outlook. Maybe the next hour, all of them are green. See next month and the next year. It's pretty rare that we get to see multiple double-digit projections from some of the AIs that we use, and we actually see a 65% trajectory for them to make it up to $50 a share. So given that, you got to look at their current levels again: $30 support and a $31.50 resistance. So that's going to mean, they're trying to continue to break above this 3150. That would be quite the breakout. But again, kind of targeting up to that $40 to $50 range. Could it be volatile? Could they retest all the way back down to 21 or even $25? It's quite possible. That's why you want to have a clear plan in place for when you're investing in companies like this so you can manage it accordingly. In fact, just this morning when we wrapped up our session where we are live, we were trading TSSI, they had sold off. And we ended up enter or exiting that position, just actually added back into the position as we saw them dip down. That position's just holding at about $22 up now after re-entering. And it's a company that's in the data center market that's pulled down significantly. A lot of data center companies recently pulled back. And so that just presents opportunities. That's how we were able to trade APLD. And in fact, when we were trading them, I wouldn't urge anybody to hold this long term because it's higher risk and there's also things like decay, so it's not always the most ideal. But for example, when we trade APLD, we'll oftentimes trade APLX. So APLX is the 2x of APLD. So again, projections looking fairly bullish. You got the next year looking bullish. Most indicators would indicate that they're growing in that data center market. So we're going to continue to watch them here into the next week here. And again, if you ever want to watch my entries, watch my exits, and see our daily live trading sessions, tune on in the second link below for StockMate. If you'd like to get first access to the Prophecy app here that we were demonstrating just a moment ago with the AI here, in this case, Claude, you can use Grok, OpenAI, or Gemini. All you have to do is click the first link down below to get on the list. Appreciate you all. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.